An opening face-off before this USP 3 contest. Stay tuned! Some hockey. As always, we thank our servicemen and women around the world protecting us here at home and our freedoms. We thank you. This evening, starting goaltenders, brought to you by MyTech Automotive. Shremsy, who do we got starting in goal? Oh, hi, Shrems. No?
What?
Hi.
Hey.
Can we get our starting
goaltender? To our right-hand side, your left-hand side, 8-3 on the season is Trevor Buchmeyer, 3.83 goals against and an 8.83 save percentage. To our left, your right-hand side, Vigo the Carpathian is out of the painting and in goal for the Potomac Patriots, Brady Boudreau, 3-9 out of the season with a 3.75 goals against and an 8.75 save percentage. Your Mizak Automotive starring goaltender Stearns.
Put that pack on the counter, it's scratchy. Wow, is the batteries dying in your wireless pack?
I actually put fresh batteries in there moments ago.
And you are scratchier than ever. Oh boy!
Likewise, something's going on between us.
No, it's his wireless pack. We'll turn him.
No, yeah. I mean you're coming in scratchier than you have all game.
Oh, we're being invaded by aliens. There you go.
We've literally done nothing in between this game to affect that.
I know, that's incredible. Anyway. Wow.
Oh. I have a Virginia Wild hockey club. Puck?
Nice. Okay. I got to turn you down. This is not working. And it's off over to the near side of the neutral zone, trying to stick it out of the air as Daytok, and he'll get charged with playing it with a high stick. Yeah, that's a lot of static there on Mr. Shrems' microphone. We'll figure out the technical details here in a moment. Faceoff will
come
down.
Did you plug it in right?
No, it is plugged in right, yeah.
Are you sure?
100%. There you go.
Are we good?
Hey.
Hey. I'm back.
A lot of wires crossing.
We don't have any wires up there. What are you talking about?
We're wireless completely, right? Half-boards, Jason Guidy with it now, back behind the goal line. He's trying to scoop it along over to the near side. He's staying with it here. Over to the near corner he goes, feeds it towards the front. Up top, Thomas Malloy with a shot. It just goes wide of Buckmeyer. Over along the far post and on the back of the net. Finally, it's poked off the back of the net. Ooh, wow, we are getting a lot of snow up here.
Season's upon us.
It is. Green with a pass ahead, and it's sticked away on the back check there. And the Generals inside of the Patriots zone along the far half boards. And it's back over into the corner. Hey, now the static is gone. And back behind over to the near corner goes into the Patriots zone. Selankiewicz couldn't keep it in there as it goes past him all the way down to Buckmeyer. 18:50 says the clock. Left here in the first period, no score. Kier with it along the near side. He'll launch this one in on Boudreaux, who will slap this one off over to the near corner. The Patriots coming off of two straight losses against the Marquette Royals and the Steel County Blades. Prior to that, they had two straight wins, 4-1, 4-0 against Blaine Energy and Alpena Flyers, that is. On the other side of it, Richmond on a three-game losing skid themselves here. 5-0 recent loss to the Jersey Hitmen. So we'll see how both teams respond. Try to beat out their losing ways here in the last 2 to 3 games. Turnaround send-in, delayed offside, was whistled dead there as the faceoff will come just outside the Richmond zone along the near side. Want to get back in the game faster? You need Mid-County Physical Therapy. MidCountyPT.com is your physical therapy one-stop shop. With their hands-on techniques, you can get back in the game faster here in Woodbridge, Virginia. Contact them today. It'll be Scott Malloy. We'll send it ahead now for Height. Tyler Height across the line. Takes this shot right into the breadbasket of Buckmeyer. Want to follow your Patriots? Follow them on Twitter, at Potomac Patriots.
Am I no longer banned, or?
Yeah, you're back. Hey.
I'm back?
You were never banned.
You said?
I lied.
You said I wasn't allowed to do this.
Well, that's not fair. You banned me before.
We're going to start our own cross-ice feed.
Up in Alberta.
The best in animal feed.
Yeah.
Manitoba animal feed under 200 pounds. Animals only under 200 pounds. Cross ice feed.
John loves his goats and kids. Over to the far corner and up top it goes. Richmond with a long shot right in on Boudreaux. He gets snowed, but he holds on and we'll get the faceoff to his right. 17:40 left here in the first, no score. Patriots Hockey is sponsored by Bill Hutzler and Pat Inslee and the Prince William Ice Center. Visit pwice.com. to learn more about skate schedules, stick and shoots, and adult hockey, and much, much more. 5180 Dale Boulevard in Woodbridge, Virginia, the Prince William Ice Center. Over into the near corner, inside the Patriots zone, trying to fight for it now. Patriots up along the near wall, can't get it out. Now finally, we'll get a push along here with Colton Heupel. Heupel sending it down over to the far corner inside the Richmond zone. Langford picking it up along the half boards. He gets squeezed off the puck there, and it'll be sent around over to the near side by Nathan Shelbert. Trying to push for it here. Peyton Norris will push it out in an effort here. Wisniewski will go for a chase here down past Soliday. Soliday will pick up the puck, though. A couple of interesting things happening behind the play there. Two players lost their twigs, Guidy being one of them. I believe Kier was the other. A little bit of contact behind the play. Maybe we'll have this one turn into a physical one. Usually the USP 3 level is one level to tends to go in that direction. Now the Richmond 1-on-5 effort here. It's Kier down low on the far side. Swept around over for Zach Chiahama. Chiahama finds a route along the near side. Pushed ahead there by Protapas. Trying to get it here is Richard Kay. Chiahama will keep it in deep. Down there with a behind-the-back pass there, trying to feed it towards the front was Protapas. He'll be taken the other way. Over for the near side for Kier. Kier trying to get around Datuk. Datuk applying some pressure here. Richard Kay, the captain, scooping it over into the near corner, but the Selankiewicz there to retrieve it. Fighting off one check, deflected up to the blue line, not out, kept in there by Chiahama. Kay couldn't handle the clear in there as Selankiewicz will put it through center. Under the tip of Kier, but it's off to his stick and on for Thomas Malloy. Malloy will get it back at his own blue line, but poked back behind him by Connor McPherson. I beg your pardon, Cohen McPherson. Over to the near side now for Jaychok. Up through center. Hit the stick of Doiron, but goes wide. No icing here. Doiron playing a bit of chase there with Nathan Shelberg. Fed along over the near side for Jones. Colin Jones sending it over to the far end. And Shelberg will chase it down here. Now through center, a breakaway chance now. Here's Jones in on goal. Takes the shot, the save by Boudreaux. Rebound left off over in the near corner. Up top, Shelberg feeds it over to Jones. And a pad save there by Boudreaux. And another save by Boudreaux. He's getting peppered, and he'll hold on. No rebound coming. Brown got the final shot in there. I believe that was Brown. I could be seeing things in there. I made that up. There probably is no Brown on this roster. Right, Durko, as I was trying to decipher all the names in the traffic in front of Boudreaux. Oh, Patriots with Heupel up ahead now. Langford in his feet, over for Heupel. Dropped off there, Gotti with a shot. Oh, it's off the post. Over to the near corner it goes. Freeland, near circle, pulls the trigger through traffic and it's blocked. And it redirects over to the far side of the zone, up top to the blue line. Malloy taking his shot, blocked. And it's cleared out into the neutral zone. Norris is going to try to catch up with it here. He left it there, though. McHenry, get a direct traffic there. As he instructs Shelberg to go over to the near side. Hilbert can get a hold of it. Shelberg will dump it in. Puck bouncing around from tape to tape here as it goes over to the half boards and up through center now. Trying to catch up with it. It's Jason Guidy. Guidy, near side, into the corner. Shelberg will pick it up, though. Shelberg scooping around over to the far side. Malloy, oh, man, broke his twig. Fortunately, the puck went further than the blade. It was a close contest. Back at the Patriots' blue line, Dooley trying to get a hold of it there. Named it along the near side. Stolen away from them, and it's cleared up by Selankiewicz into the Patriots' zone. Kier in a foot race there with Spencer Weck. Weck has him tied up. Over to the far end now. Trying to get a hold of it there. It was Irizarry. Over the near half boards it goes. Patriots to find an exit strategy here along the red line. Dooley lost control of it there. Kier with the lead pass ahead now. Across the line. And on goal with a shot, he scores. Austin Petrie goes top shelf, and it's 1-0 Richmond. 13:41 left here in the first. I don't have my cricket sound effect cued. There it is. So back and forth, battle between these two teams ends up with Richmond striking first here. 1-0 left here in the first period. Ah, there's the twig. Thomas Malloy's other half there. We got to put it inside the Richmond bench and we'll continue on here. So we are a little bit earlier than originally scheduled, but let's get Johnny on the call in the Richmond goal.
Richmond Generals goal.
Who was that second assist there, John?
Selankiewicz. No, number 38, Aaron Selankiewicz.
The second assist or the first assist?
Oh, that's the first. The second assist is number 77, Robert Tibbs, who no, is not on your roster, but he was in the starting lineup. Way to pay attention.
I don't really pay attention to you much, John, but thanks. Now,
what's that, Dave?
What? I'm sorry, I turned you off. Faceoff will be to the left of Brady Boudreaux.
I think this would be the perfect opportunity for the first period Tato Skins trivia question. Tato Skins, always made with real potato skins. The question for this week, who was the first NHL team to have a goal horn? The first NHL team to have a goal horn, a true goal horn like you hear today. Not a buzzer, not a siren, but a goal horn.
I'm going to go with Hartford Whalers.
Instant thoughts, Toronto.
And can you give me the decade that it's in? And both of you are wrong. Potato Skins trivia question of the moment.
Tweet us your answers at Cross Ice Feed. Here's a shot spun around over to the near side, half forwards and up to the blue line. Not out, kept in there by Jack Scott with a shot right in on Krishnan. And he got in the way of that one. And Boudreaux will pick it up. And we got to guess that it's the Red Wings. What? Who? Nordiques. Oh, in the 80s? That's Phil's answer.
Not the Red Wings.
What? He said Nordique. I'm sorry, Snowy.
I swear you said Red Wings just now.
No, he said Nordiques. So, Snowy Shrems. Is it the Nordiques?
You're both terrible at the Tato Skins trivia question.
So, was it the Sabres? That's amazing.
The Sabres.
Oh. My God. So it was Pittsburgh in 1980s.
Canadian's goal horn does sound like it's on its last leg every single time. However, it is not the Canadiens either.
I said Penguins. Wow, you guys have problems hearing me down there. Oh, my goodness. Point shot blocked up front there. Now it's going to be taken the other direction by the Patriots.
Rangers?
And it's going to be let's wait for a stoppage. Let's wait for a stoppage here. We got a game to call. It's up in the neutral zone. Patriots trying to gain control of it here. Back at their own blue line. Now it's Freeland. Freeland across the red line, across the blue line. He'll take a shot wide here. Looking for an opportunity for Patapas to try to catch up with it. And now comes out to the neutral zone. It's Colin Jones now with it. Jones stopping at the half ball. Sends it down. I was right. There is a Brown out there. It's number 28. It's not on my roster either. And now, turnaround shot there from Zach Shiahama. Goes wide of the goal, along the far half boards. Richard Kay with it. Yes, Snow, is that you again?
You want 28?
Oh, and a hard check delivered there by Durko. And here's a point shot. Yeah, Brown, what's his first name?
I got Marcianti, that's all I have.
Marcianti?
I will have to Google and find out if he has a first name.
For number 28, it says Brown on the back of his sweater.
Well, on the score sheet, it says Marcianti.
All right, Marcianti. Okay. All righty then. Now the Patriots through neutral up for Height. At the red line, across the blue line, he goes. Height dropping it off there for Dorian. Dorian takes a shot and a pad saved by Buckmeyer. 10:08 left here in the first. 1-0 Richmond. Along the near side and out in the neutral zone, Height. Behind the back there for Malloy. Malloy trying to push it ahead, but Pierce will get a hold of it here. Pierce along the near wing for Norris. And it's clear back into the Richmond zone, but not deep there as Hilbert. Trying to get a hold of it there. Malloy pushing it back there. Krishnan, who gets checked off the puck as he got his pass. And Pierce took him out. Back and forth between the blue lines it goes. Dorian will dump it in deep enough there for the Patriots to get their changes out there.
Phil Marcianti.
Phil Marcianti. I think you're
number 28 on your roster, one in your hearts.
Okay. McHenry, far corner. He gets taken down by, two Patriots who also went down with him. Along the near side, Heupel. Heupel with it now with a little drag move. Takes a shot to flex off the inside of the leg of Hilbert. Now long over. Through center now off the ankle of Vreeland. Down the ice, no icing. Boudreaux way out of his cage here to play it up along the near wing. Out of the tape of Guidey, who will guide this one down. Behind the goal line, Buckmeyer feeding around over to the far half boards. Green coming back over to the far corner and swept around over to the near side. Richmond finally getting it out through neutral. Pitra with the only goal in this contest will have it now. Pitra trying to get it on for Green. Green got played like a fiddle by Soliday. The puck remains inside the Patriots zone up top for Scott. Scott, near blue line. Sending it down to the corner. Soliday will get there ahead of Kier. Kept along by Pitra down low. And on now for Green. Between the legs passer for Pitra, but Pitra couldn't deliver it home. Turns over on a pass here for Kay. Two on two the other way. Colton Heupel. Cross the line. Drop pass there for Kay. Kay. And he had a shot poked away from Jack Scott. Goes over to the near side. Petrie across the line. He goes into the Patriots zone. Far circle. Stops, turns, looks. Defensemen are changing here. Well, one of them at least. Green with a redirect shot. They score. I believe Kier may have gotten a piece of that up front. I'm not sure if it was him that had the redirect or if it was the Patriots defense, but it's 2-0 Richmond. 7:52 left here in the first. There was nothing stopping that one. So on the seventh Richmond shot, they have a 2-0 lead. Shh, quiet. Tiger's putting. Wait, didn't he retire from golf?
Not yet.
Not yet. Should. Hasn't. We got a call from John. If he's still there.
Richmond General's goal was for a number 77, Robert Tibbs. Assistant by Commander King, Connor Green. Number 83, Austin Petrie. That's Tibbs from Green and Petrie.
Christian, near circle. Looking to backhander towards the front. Nobody there to gun it home. Richmond will take it away. Leading it up along the far side of the neutral zone. What a team effort there on a check. But Richmond continues on here with Colin Jones. Looking for an opportunity to bank it in. And that's Lankwitz having to control it back for McPherson. McPherson trying to push it out here along the near side. He gets it out of the tape of Colin Jones. Jones now on for Wisniewski. Poked away, and Height will take it now. Height. And he tries to move it through center for Nayenden, but out of his reach it goes. Now through center. By the way, I got to mention that this is a full, healthy roster for Potomac. Coach Little was tickled pink when he realized that today would be the first day he'd have a full, healthy roster. Now we got a call coming up here. It's going to go to Richmond. I don't know if anything else is going to come of it, but Wisniewski's going to go sit. And Malloy, I don't know, he's... Wisniewski's going back after Malloy. I'm not sure if anything's going to come of it. Now Wisniewski's challenging the Patriots bench.
A little bit of chirping going on out there.
Oh, he got a misconduct on top of it. Oh, boy. Tripping a misconduct. Uh-oh. Be 2-10? No, the referee's...
2-10 down here, Stearns.
Well, somebody's
good opportunity for the Pats to make something of this power play and get themselves back in this game. 6:30 left to go here in the first period. Down 2-0. Haven't looked too bad so far, but got to capitalize here.
And a shorthanded try here from Hilbert, and he gets taken out. Oh, well, he may have gotten away with one there. It was Daytac that took him out.
Richmond Generals penalty number 97, Reed Wisniewski. 2 minutes for tripping and a 10-minute misconduct. Wisniewski, 2 for tripping, 10 for misconduct at 6:30. On the cross ice, he out of play.
Langford couldn't control it. Malloy trying to poke it to keep it in. You're saying it's 77 is actually Tibb, huh? Tibbs?
Yes.
And he's got Kier on the back of his jersey. So confused.
Well, unless they falsified the score sheet, Dave, it says Tibbs.
It's a funny way of spelling Tibbs. I didn't know Tibbs started with a K. Okay. And here's Gardy. Gardy down along the near goal line. Up top, he finds Doiron. Far side with a shot teed up. Goes wide, but caught up by Shelberg, and he'll find open ice and sends it all the way down to Boudreaux. Boudreaux, wasting no time, finds it on for Guidi, trying to catch Richmond on a change. He'll set it up here, and a bouncing puck up to the blue line. They're going to rule that it came out. So a delayed offside. This one's sent all the way down to Boudreaux. And we got 45 seconds left on the cross-ice feed power play. 5-10 left here in the first. 2-0 Richmond. Richard Kay getting checked on the boards there by Colin Jones. Petra with it now. Trying to kill some time. Now Jones down there as well. Soliday cleared up top. Pierce took a shot and he broke a twig. Got a bunch of lumberjacks out there. A lot of twigs going down. Kay, far circle. Lines up, takes the shot and deflects out of the protective netting. 4:47 left here in the first. 17 seconds left on the cross ice feed power play.
I think now is the appropriate time to answer the Tato Skins trivia question of the period. We've guessed just about every single team in the entire...
I don't got it, and it's bugging me, so I hope for an answer real soon.
One last guess, gentlemen.
Edmonton.
Not Edmonton.
Calgary.
It is the Chicago Blackhawks.
Ah.
In the decades of the 60s.
Ah.
I believe mid-60s, 65. But don't hold me to it. I just called for the decade.
And a hard check there. One of the timekeeper's box, rattling some microphones down low. And that'll do it for the cross-ice feed power play. It wasn't very powerful. 4:25 left here in the first. 2-0 Richmond. We need to call Novak and find out where the power went in that power play. Granted, they are operating at 11%. Stats never lie. Along the near side, they have some work to do. They really do, but we'll see what they can deliver here. Looking at the standings, Patriots have only 7 wins on the season. Richmond with 21. And a hard check up there by McHenry on to Krishnan. Across the line is Doyron trying to move it ahead there for Krishnan, breaking towards the net. Top of the slot, puck's there. Blue line kept in by Height. That one sent off over into the near corner. Norris down to the tape of Selankiewicz, who clears it in and fights off a couple of checks. And next he'll take on the Russians. Towards the front of the net, Height will scoop it away. Up now, Datok for Doyron. Doyron getting checked there by McPherson. And that ship has sailed, and Doyron will go off on a change. Norris along the near side, trying to get a pass ahead off the boards. Hype will intercept. Try to push it through all the traffic along the near boards. Puck went to Datok. Let's turn back over here. Here's Brown taking a shot and a pass saved by Boudreau. The rebound by Norris taking a shot. Goes wide over to the far half boards with another shot blocked up front there. And now a little bit of miscommunication through all the traffic at the high slot. And Norris will dump it right back in as things came out into the neutral zone for just a mere hot second. Through center it goes. McPherson will tee this one back up and send it in along the near corner. Boudreau dropping it off there for Spencer Weck. Weck up ahead now, far wing. Under the tape there of Noah Langford. Kicking it ahead here, Langford. Taking the shot and the rebound. Buckmeyer couldn't swallow it up, but it went behind the cage. Now McPherson tying up his man. The puck is pushed away there. And now the Generals are going to take it back the other direction. 4-on-3, and Scott will dump it in here. Durko will pick it up over in the near corner. Feeding it towards the front. Now Heupel, over the far circle. He'll stay with it here as it's guided out to the red line. He'll go off in a change. Pierce will turn it around, send it in to the near corner. Colin Jones will meet it. Jones doing battle here up against Soliday. Soliday. They have it stuck in their feet. Shiahama in there to support. Time ticks down. 1:40 left here in the first. 2-0 Richmond. Puck finally set free by Patrick Patapas. Now it's turned over, and it's poked away by the Patriots. Close call there, Richard Kay. Going to get a solid rep on it here. He gets some back support from Soliday. No call coming up there. A little bit of bumping at the blue line. Looking for something, and it ain't going to come. Let them play. Let them play. In front of the Patriots bench it is. We come down to the 1 minute mark. Scoreboard keeps on freaking out for some reason. And now it's going to be picked up here along the near side of the neutral zone by Shiahama, trying to get it away from his check from Shelberg. Shelberg staying with him there. Pierce will poke the puck in along the near wing. They're down under a minute. Now it's batted out of the air and down low. Behind the goal line, Pierce will find it. Over the near corner, Shelberg. Back over to the far corner for Pierce. It's becoming more of a tennis match. Table tennis, that is. And it goes down over to the near corner yet again, and there it is for Tibbs. Tibbs off the shin pad there of Doyron, and he'll dump it back in with 20 seconds to play here in the first. Now a 2-on-1 developing the other way. Here's Petra looking for one, breaking towards an end, a save by Boudreau. He got over just in the nick of time to stop the one-timer. 10 seconds left, one last chance here. Selankiewicz going wide with it. Malloy will catch up with it on the half boards. 5 seconds to play here. And that is how the first period will end. 2-0 in this USP3 contest. Richmond in the lead. 2-0 over your Potomac Patriots. Stay tuned. We'll be back in a moment's time. Welcome back to the Prince William Ice Center here in Woodbridge, Virginia. Second period just about to get underway between the Richmond Generals and your Potomac Patriots in this USP3 contest. Currently, the Richmond Generals are in the driver's seat with the two-goal lead. As they always say, the two-goal lead is the most dangerous lead in hockey. If you're Brian Schrems, you think otherwise.
The music's too loud. I can't hear you.
Yeah, and... You're quiet again, so.
What?
Turn it up.
Turn up your speakers.
No, it's maxed.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, shame.
Turn up the radio.
Okay, fine. Here, how about that?
Better.
I didn't do anything. Faceoff coming up at center ice here to start off the second period. Potomac, how do they got to respond to this one, gentlemen?
By turning up the radio.
Really?
Yeah, you're going to turn
really?
It up.
Really? No. That's not how it works. Ah, my goodness. What are you hearing us on anyway? No, we're good. We are to the max here at the Prince William Ice Center. We're going to be back here in a couple weeks' time, and after this home-and-home series concludes, they're going to take on Hampton Roads Whalers down at the Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex. We'll be back here in a few weeks. Face-off over.
What arena? The Chico's Bail Bonds Arena?
The Chilled Ponds. And now is a chance. Guidey into the slot. Takes the shot and it goes over the cage and out of play. And a little pushing and shoving ensues. And an extra whistle here and there. Let's see what transpires out of this. Is somebody going to go a power play here?
Well, now seems like the best time ever to introduce your Planters cheese balls. Trivia question for the second period. Planters cheese balls, always cheesy, always circular. Your trivia question is, what is the highest... Well, I'm going to hold.
Here comes a breakaway with Norris. Norris across the line. Comes and takes a nice shot. It's saved by Boudreau.
Stuck with the shooter on that one, Boudreau, but he's got good ice vision tonight.
Slagwitz
and there's
takes
a glove.
Shot. There's more proof in the pudding. Boudreau making yet another save. 19-25. Yes, I'm talking pudding. But Shrimps is talking cheese balls in the sandstorm.
Yeah, yeah. Back to your cheese, your Planters cheese balls. Trivia question for the second period. The highest grossing hockey film of all time. And a bonus if you get number two. Number two is probably harder than number one. However, you cannot sit here and guess because of such a limited market of items to choose from.
Here's a point shot going wide.
You get one guess in the next 5 minutes when I call for the answer.
All right. At Cross Ice Feed is the Twitter handle, and we'll get another stoppage here at the Prince William Ice Center. We are not monitoring the chat feature in Fast Hockey, so you'll have to give us your answer via Twitter or email. contact@crossicefeed.com. Highest grossing hockey film, and what is the second one? Number one and number two. I want to say it's Mighty Ducks 2 is the top grossing, and the second one would be Mystery Alaska. And it's Petrie putting it over to the far circle with a shot. Boudreau to save the rebound. It trickles in. Richmond is up 3-0. That one just squirted its way back behind Boudreau and in. 18:56 left here in the second period. So I say Mighty Ducks 2 and Mystery Alaska. And now Phil is saying Miracle and then Mighty Ducks 2 is his guess. So Phil got it right. I can't believe it. And the faceoff through center now along the time.
Trem simply said, okay, next stoppage I'll give my thoughts.
Did you hear Phil's? It was Miracle and Ducks 2.
Miracle and Ducks 2. Mighty Ducks 2.
And over to the far end of the neutral zone it goes, and it's scooped in by the Patriots. Not deep enough here. Now it'll be deflected through neutral, caught up at the Patriots' blue line. Brown checking Malloy. A little bit of action going along here with Irizarry getting tied up something here or another. And Richmond trying to get it inside the Patriots' zone. Delayed offside. And they'll whistle this one down. 18-13 left here in a second. Trent, what do we got?
All right, so the obvious answer seems to be Miracle. Recent Disney movie, big release.
I backed away from it completely.
But I'm going to say Sudden Death. Followed by Miracle.
Oh, wow. So we got a variety of answers.
Action film, Jean-Claude Van Damme. Penguins were big at the time. Hockey is not the key to, is not the plot. That's my guess.
Watch it be like, what was the one?
There's a John Wayne hockey movie from the 30s I've never seen. So, I mean,
what?
It could be something completely random.
No way.
Yeah, there is. I don't know what it is offhand, but there is one.
I'll get it from him.
What were the goal score? What was the goal announcement there, John?
Richmond Generals goals come out number 77, Robert Tibbs, assisted by number 18, Connor Green, and number 83, Austin Petrie. That's Tibbs from Green and Petrie, and 18-56.
I was getting the inquiry up here. It'll be put out on the Richmond Generals Twitter. Long near side, no length for trying to deflect it out in the neutral zone. Kept in there by Pearson, scooped up by Brady Boudreau. So, did we decide what the answer is? Okay. We will never know. Faceoff will be to the right of Brady Boudreau. One off over to the near half boards and trying to clear it out. It's Malloy. Malloy got tripped up behind the play. No call. Petra in on goal. Takes a shot. Oh, he scores. He goes top cheese, and it's 4-0 Richmond. 17:03 left here in a second. We're shaking it off up here, 4-0. We'll get the call. And here comes a chance, Tim scores, 5-0. And he hops into the glass. 16:42 left here in the second. They're running away with this one. And they're going to change up the goaltenders. Mikkel Minnell is going to come in now for Brady Boudreau.
Goaltending change with Mikkel Minnell. 1-6 on the season, 4.96. Goals against average and an 880 save percentage. Mikkel Minnell, we saw him a couple of weeks ago over on the NHL side. This team put in a fantastic performance against the best team in the league, the Hampton Roads Whalers, but fell short in the third period. Nonetheless, Minnell put in a pretty sound performance in that game, if I do remember correctly.
You are correct. It was an exciting finish. 3-2 loss, but it was within the final 3 minutes. So it was pretty interesting.
Hat trick for Tibbs.
I love that band. Over to the near corner it goes. Up along the near side and at the Patriots zone. Patriots needing to find some sort of help here. So Richmond looks to overtake third place and possibly get, well, they'll be in a tie for second place depending on how Carolina does this evening. Richmond will be tied at 46 points if they carry on at this momentum and take the victory. That'll put them 4 points behind first place Hampton Roads that sit at 50 points. Up along the near side now, inside of the Richmond zone, pass up for Norris. Norris can't clear it inside of the Patriots zone. The Patriots are going to come back the other way. It's Dooley trying to poke it away. But Richmond will find an opening along the near side. Malloy will tap it right back in, though. Back over to the near corner. Dooley getting popped up high there by Pierce. A little bit of a pushing and shoving going here now along the near boards. Hilbert and Dooley. Dooley up top to Malloy. Malloy taking a shot and a save there by Buckmeyer, who sees his fifth shot or sixth shot.
Yeah, so now seems like the appropriate time to give the answer to the Planters Cheese Balls trivia question for the second period. Your highest grossing film is Miracle.
Ah, okay.
Falling just short by about $4.5 million. Tooth Fairy. Tooth Fairy.
But now with a great pat save, Tooth Fairy
was classified officially as a special film, specialized sports film, because
the
main character was a hockey player.
Tooth
Fairy, your second highest grossing NHL film, hockey-based film.
That's disturbing.
D1 and D2 were after that at 3 and 4.
That's disturbing.
You're welcome.
I'm going to go home and watch Mystery Alaska to feel better about that. Love that movie. And Scott putting it through the neutral zone along the near side. Pitre over to the far circle for Brown. Brown trying to backhand it for Scott. Heupel tried to find it on for Lankford, who had a breakaway opportunity if he hurried, but the puck just wasn't there. Up at the red line, behind the back pass there, Heupel across the line. Heupel, far circle with a shot. Steered aside easily by Buckmeyer. A point shot there. Guidey with the turnaround shot, and a better save there by Buckmeyer on a great opportunity from Jason Guidey. Wisniewski rejoins his team after his extended period of time in the sin bin. .1346 left here in a second. It's 5-0 Richmond Generals. Visitors taking control here. Durko trying to clear it out there. He does so successfully, but it's picked up by Shiahama just outside the blue line. Backhanding it towards the slot. And it's cleared out by the Richmond Generals and down the length of the ice. Shiahama racing for it there to get ahead of Brown. And Brown poked it away from him for a moment. Durko.
So what Bob.
Excuse me. Bobbles on over to Manel. And I should have bought coffees for everybody. I'm sorry. I got mouths to feed at home. Four of them to be exact, including a mouse that's in my house. 13:23 left here in the second. 5-0 Richmond. Now one back up top here to the Generals. Selankwith pulls the trigger. Nice pad save by Manel. Almost doing the splits there for that one. On the front of the Richmond bench, gunned around over to the near side. Up at the blue line, Durko. A redirect up front, almost put in by his own player, Malloy. That is steered aside by Eminem. Turned over, here's Height, taking the shot and a block. By Selankwitz, he turned it over initially. Selankwitz lucky to be there at the right place at the right time. No trip call there. The fans want a tripping call, but they won't get one. Colin Jones. And now here's a call coming up to the Patriots. I believe it's Colton Heupel that's going to sit for two or less. 12:38 left here in the second. This one's getting a little crazy. Little ex-girlfriend crazy. We'll see where this goes. Durko's going to get charged with it. Wow.
He's got to watch his spending. He just got two for charging. Am I right? Am I right, everyone? Here we go.
Well done. Well done, you.
Oh.
Cross Ice Feed Power Play. Follow us on Twitter at Cross Ice Feed.
beef up that 9% power play percentage, Stearns. Let's get one here.
9. I got 11.3 on my sheet.
Oh, my stats are off.
Yes, they are, just ever so slightly. Unless I'm printing out old information.
Wouldn't surprise me.
I am a little old school. Pertapis across the line. Top of the slot. Looking to pull the trigger. Holds on to it. Feathers it down low for Langford. Langford with it far circle. Trying to push it up top, and it redirects out of the reach of Doyren and goes over to the near side of the neutral zone. Back inside of his own zone to regroup. Doyren up ahead now for Guidi. Guidi pushing along over to the far side for Pertapis. Pertapis. Langford. Langford. Back over for Pertapis, and he has it taken out of his reach, and it'll be pushed up by Tibbs. Tibbs shorthanded, far circle, drops it off there for Hilbert. Hilbert gets checked hard, solid A. Now we're going to get a call here to the Patriots. And they're still going at it, and Hilbert's going back, and Hilbert throws a few punches at solid A. I guess maybe the two of them will go now instead of just one, because misery loves company. 11:23 left here in a second. 45 seconds up there on the board still for Durko's penalty. Soliday will sit for two, and Hilbert is going to go. So we'll get the calls here from Johnny B. So we got Soliday's penalty up on the board. 4 minutes up there on the board for Soliday. And 2 minutes up on the board. Wow, all right. Well, we will get these calls from Johnny B. Dooley will sit for the front two, I'm guessing. Oh, okay, so it's only two. All right, so the two will offset, and we'll only have a two up there. Well, that's disappointing. I was looking forward to 4-on-3 hockey. Open things up a little bit. 11:23 left here in the second. This one's starting to turn a touch interesting. We'll get the calls here in a moment as this one's up along the far half boards. Johnny's doing his homework diligently. And now let's check his math. And there we go. But wait, there's more. Well, that's it. That's how things shake out. All right. So a double minor to Solid A and just a single minor to Hilbert. Along the near side of the neutral zone, Pertapis trying to steal it away from Slankwitz. Here comes Pertapis in our goal. Buckmeyer comes out in time to poke it away. Height will try to pick up the loose puck there. And nothing will come of that as the Generals have a home run pass waiting for Durko. Went out the race for the icing. Uh-oh. Eminem's got to get back. Nice stick save there as he stopped that one up from going towards the cage. Crazy pressure. He almost had like this Hasek-esque look on his face there when he was coming out of the net like that. Now Buckmeyer had just done the same thing a second ago, but actually collided with the Patriots player, and he'll swallow up here as the puck, as the faceoff will come up to his left. 10:13 left in the second. 50 seconds left on the man advantage for the Richmond Generals. We'll have this faceoff to the left of Buckmeyer. Trevor Buckmeyer, 8-3 on the season. 383 on the goals against average. 88% on the save percentage. You heard in the MyTech Automotive starting goaltenders. Here comes Green, in on goal. Takes a shot, Mikkel Minnell makes the save. No rebound coming. He holds onto it. 10:05 left here in the second. 5-0 Richmond. Patriots looking for their offensive touch, but they can't really put any offense together here. They're shorthanded, but hopefully on the other side of that, they can get things moving. Cardinals are currently up on the Packers, 7-0. 5:33 left of the first quarter of that one. That is your score update. Around over to the near side. McPherson will keep it in along the near blue line. Half a minute left to kill on the All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater penalty kill. McPherson taking a shot. It goes deflecting out of play. Faceoff coming up inside the Patriots zone. Patriots hockey is sponsored by the Spine and Joint Institute of Fairfax, Virginia. Visit sjinstitute.com. For your family wellness, sports medicine, and chiropractic needs, you need Dr. Maria Schaefer and Dr. Felix Yeskin to help you address all of your needs with the SJ Institute. Visit sjinstitute.com. Durko with along the near half wall being pressured by Tyler Height. Being forced down over to the near corner. And Durko will have it now. Spins around with a shot and a save there in the glove of Mikkel Munell. He holds on. 12 seconds left to kill. 2 weeks' time, we'll be back here at the Prince William Ice Center. Carolina Eagles come soaring into town. 31st. Man, they do have that game slated for 9 p.m. for the USP 3. I hope it
Use me?
Yeah, 9 p.m.
When?
Saturday, January 30th.
Oh, I'm washing my hair that night.
Yeah, that's my bridge night, too. We'll have to figure something else out. This one sent down along the ice, no icing.
Is the elite game scheduled for
6 o'clock, yes.
Holy jumping.
Yeah, something crazy must be going on here at the Prince William Ice Center.
Is that a four-game weekend for us?
Yes, it is.
Are they pushing the games up on Sunday?
No.
Of course. Good heavens.
Yeah, why would they do that? Party at my house. It's going to be a sleepover watching Frozen and Thomas and Friends and popcorn and juice boxes.
I'm in for Thomas and Friends.
Yep, my daughter Maggie absolutely loves Thomas and Friends.
Because everyone loves Thomas the Tank Engine.
I know.
I grew up on that stuff.
She's even got a little model one, too. It's really cool.
No,
just
you know
one?
You know who's back with a vengeance? LeVar Burton with Reading Rainbow.
Yes, yeah. He is.
They funded him $1 million on Kickstarter.
Oh, yeah. It's awesome how that works.
You got to get Maggie hooked on that.
I know. Butterfly in the sky. Yeah. And off over in the near corner and Patriots territory. Richmond fighting for it here. Petro will peel away with it. He started things off here with the first goal of this game. And here is Airy with it over to the far circle. Trying to clear it out. Kept in there. Far blue line. Selankiewicz putting it down deep. Petra trying to stuff it towards the front for Tibbs. Tibbs has a hat trick in this game. And it's going to be cleared down the length of the ice by Nayandin. Caught up here by the Generals. Here is Airy doing some forechecking. I beg your pardon, it's Daytok. Or Dooley. Dooley. One of the 20s. Daytok's up here in the neutral zone. Some changes for the Patriots. Nice pressure there by Eminem. They cleared up towards the blue line and out. And caught up there by Wisniewski, who will clear it right back in. Long half boards it goes for Daytok. Daytok trying to find it up for Langford. And Langford trying to deliver a hip check there on Pierce. He gets a check off. But it'll be taken the other direction. Langford and Heupel trying to work it down low. Heupel catching up with it over the far half boards. But it'll be poked out by the Generals. Long over to the front of the bench. And in front of his own bench, it's Wisniewski leading the charge. Being back checked there by Wick, and a save there by Manil. Over to the near corner, Vreeland. Going toe to toe there with Wisniewski, and he got the pass away as he got checked. And that was cleared right into the linesman. That's a stinger. Now the Generals, 2-on-1 towards the net. Pass goes wide, and over to the near half boards, cleared up along the glass and out by the Patriots. Heupel trying to split through two. And now we have a hand pass ruled, and we have a delayed call coming up here. And it looks like Guidey's going to be sitting for two or less. As Wisniewski slaps a stick on the ice and waves at his girlfriend. 6:51 left here in the second. With the Wisniewski fan club. Well, off to our left. For all things Potomac Patriots, PotomacPatriots.net is your one-stop shop for all things from mites to juniors, to Lady Patriots, to sled hockey. Also follow them on Twitter at Potomac Patriots and like them on Facebook. Facebook page keeping everyone up to date on all things Potomac Patriots. Here's a call. See All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater penalty kill. 6:38 left here in the second. 5-0 Richmond. Up top it goes. Forward to the Generals, controlling it inside of the Patriot zone. Shelburne was quarterbacking it up top. Now down for Durko along the near corner. Durko up top for Green. Back to Durko, half wall. Durko down into the near corner. On his backhand. Swinging it over to the far side. Shelberg's going to have to work for it over on the far blue line. He'll keep it in. Back over to the far half boards. Austin Pitra over for Green along the near side. Down over to the near corner for the captain, Durko. James Durko, and now we're going to get ourselves a call here. It looks like both of them are going. Doiron and Durko. I'm hearing both of you. So, yes. Everybody's getting a turn in the penalty box. Seriously, it's like the Oprah Winfrey show, you know? You're getting a penalty, you're getting a penalty, you're all getting a penalty! Oh. Well,
hey, Stearns, we have an embellishment penalty being called.
To Durko?
Yeah.
Wow. I have not seen that at this level. I don't think ever. That is something else. Anybody watch that clip of the Bruins referee? Oh, what a great glove save there by Minnell. We'll get the call.
Dang. Minnell looks pretty good so far in relief here.
I like it. I got to find the clip. I think that's right. John, you shared it with us. The Bruins game where the referee got caught saying something about embellishment. Give us a call. A shot and a save off the crossbar. Oh, baby. And it's cleared down the length of the ice here. 20 seconds left to kill on Guidi's penalty. 5:12 left here in the second. 5-0 Richmond.
Man, McPherson has got an absolute rocket from the point.
I was talking with Alan, our PR guy, and he was saying he's 6'5", 235 pounds or something or another. But, oh, my goodness, he's a monster. And a glove save there by Mikkel Munell. 4:50 left here in the second. We're back to even strength. Patriots Hockey is sponsored by MyTech Automotive, located here in Woodbridge, Virginia. Visit MyTechAutoInc.com to schedule your vehicle maintenance today. And it's won by the Generals. Up top, Green finds Selenkowitz. Selenkowitz pulls the trigger and a save there by the blocker and stick of M&M, Mikkel Munell. Irizarry with it now. He'll clear it in. Dooley trying to stay onside. He does so. Buckmeyer getting it back behind. Warselankwitz over to the far corner. Buckmeyer's got to be getting cold. He's only had 9 shots, and we got 4:30 left here, 4:29 left here in the second period. Patriots need to get more shots on him. Patriots are sponsored by Glory Days Grill, located at Potomac Mills. Visit your local Glory Days Bar and Grill today. Up top it goes. And Soliday couldn't keep it in. He'll have to chase it back into his own zone. Vreeland with it now on the D-to-D. Through center. Nandon couldn't get a hold of it there. And Generals will tap it right back in over to the near corner. Soliday there to chase. Gets checked by Green. Wins the battle for the puck. Over now for Vreeland. Vreeland losing it there at the half boards, but it'll combine efforts there with Dooley to take his check into the boards. Nandon in there to support as the puck slowly creeps its way towards the blue line. And now we have a delayed call coming up, presumably to the Patriots. As it goes off in the near corner, we'll get that call. 3:50 left here in a second. The score sheet is slowly but surely filling up. Not with goals, that's for sure. It'll be Kyle Dooley that'll sit for two or less. with the call. Coming up. And there's a shot. They score. It's Pitra along the far post. He guns it in. They didn't waste any time there. 8 ticks into the man advantage. It's 6-0. Richmond, 3:42 left here in a second. Well, quite a hole to climb out of, 6-0. And here's the call in a moment. Well, we got a penalty and a goal to talk about, and Norris trying to put it towards the front of the net. They're stolen away from Gunny. Power 25-11, shots in favor of Richmond along with a score of 6-0. 3:10 left here in the second. Next weekend, the guys will take on the Hampton Roads Whalers, who are dominating the USP 3 South. 24 wins, 8 losses, 2 overtime losses, 50 points. 131 goals for and 89 goals against. That is insane. Patriots are definitely on the opposite end of the spectrum. They got a lot of rebuilding to do here, or try to find a silver lining on their season to come down to the final 9 games. And it's back along over the near side of the Patriots zone, controlled by Scott. Scott sending it down for Colin Jones out of his reach. Goes over to the far corner. And trying to pick it up here, the Patriots. Matoyer in the head now and along the near side for Richard Kay, the captain. His pass is intercepted by Stalenkowitz. Stalenkowitz will pick it back up as Generals lost it there in the neutral zone for a moment. Mikkel Minnell allowing 1 goal so far in relief. And oh, wow, he stops another one from going in. What a stack pad effort there along the far post. We'll get a stoppage, 2:15 left here in the second period. Mikkel Minnell throwing out some great saves regardless. Do you have a Dunkaroos trivia question lined up for the third there, Shrubsy?
Why don't you relax a little bit, okay? Relax. The one I got coming up in the third is a really, like, legit trivia question.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it actually the Spinojoid Institute trivia question? There's a shot deflected away. Solid A. I think Pierce was looking for the redirect. 2 minutes left here in a second. I know we're a little earlier than scheduled. According to the website, it said we were going to get things started at 8:20 tonight. I beg your pardon, 7:50. Okay, so we're on time. I don't know where I got 8:20 from. Magical schedule that I came up with in my own head. We have a delayed call coming up, and I have one guess on who it's going to be against. Oh, wait, maybe not. Well, interference is a call, and it's going to be Pierce. I jumped the gun. Literally, I jumped the gun. Nice segue, John. Face off to the right of Buckmeyer. And it's one up top. Suddenly we got caught in a sandstorm. The tap is down over the far half boards. Now Guidi try to work it. And it's stolen and sent down the length of the ice by the Generals. It's a Cross Ice Feed power play. Follow us on Twitter at Cross Ice Feed. Like us on Facebook. And Daytok trying to pull it through, but It's cleared up by the Generals. To the red line. We're down to 1 minute left here in the second period. Patriots looking to crack that egg up there on the board. That's Malloy. Along the half boards. Got a wrestle for it from Hilbert. He's got Guidi. Some support down there. And now we're going to get a call to Jason Guidi. Forty-two seconds left. What's another penalty? We're gonna see 4-on-4 action for the next minute and two. Carry over into the third period.
Well, better late than never. I'm going to ask my Spina Joint Institute of Fairfax trivia question. Not to rain on Trems' parade, but I've been here longer.
This is the Dunkaroos one, don't worry.
Right, right. He has his own sponsors. The longest non-shutout streak, that's a team not getting a shutout for how long, is the same number for if you include the playoffs or if you don't with two different teams. Name either one. The number 264. 264 consecutive non-shutout games.
Who is it? Okay.
I have a guess, but I'm going to wait till the very end.
Okay, 15 seconds left here. 4-on-4 hockey ensues. Here comes Kay. Trying to set it up here into the slot. Nobody there. And so the Patriots lose an opportunity here to get some silver lining in this period, but that's how it'll end here. For the second frame, it's 6-0 Richmond in this USP3 USPHL tilt between Richmond Generals and the Potomac Patriots. Richmond in the driver's seat of this Mack truck. Carryover penalties make it 4-on-4 for 20 seconds, and then a 58-second power play on the other side for the Richmond Generals. Stay tuned here on the feed. Forty minutes down, 20 minutes more. 6-0 is your score. Johnny, won't you shut the door?
Dave, stop rhyming evermore.
Sure. Lenore.
Reminds me of your days of yore when you like to rhyme everything more.
Well, what do we have in store here? 6-0 is
both
your
of you
score.
What? Shut up.
Give us our Dunkaroos question, will you? Here we go. Third period underway and the faceoff one ahead. Now the Patriots slowing the trigger finger there. Krishnan trying to get it over to the opposite D, and Malloy couldn't get a hold of it there. It's out of the neutral zone. And it'll be launched right back in. And at the top of the slot here is the Generals green. Puts it through all the traffic, and this one's going to be icing. Charged against the Richmond Generals, who are now on a power play for the next 55 seconds with that stoppage. 19:37. Left here in the third, 6-0 Richmond Generals. Potomac Patriots Hockey is sponsored by Mid-County Physical Therapy. With their hands-on techniques, you can get back in the game faster. Visit midcountypt.com for Mid-County Physical Therapy located here in Woodbridge, Virginia. One off over to the far corner. Selankiewicz puts it over to the near side for Shelberg into the corner. Shelberg looking for an out here. Guidi has 45 seconds left to serve on his All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater penalty kill. Well, penalty. And it goes off over to the far corner of the Patriot zone, and they'll launch it down for Shelberg to pick it up in the far circle of his own zone. He'll retreat back behind his tender. Vertapas in there to apply some pressure. And Shelberg will go to the opposite wing to the far side, and Pierce with a touch pass there between the legs for Green. Green. He'll lose control of it, though, and it'll come up to the blue line. Not out. Kipped in there by Pierce. Pierce trying to pull the shot through Shiahama. Shiahama blocked it. Lost a twig. He'll pick it back up again. And the puck is along the far half boards for Selankiewicz into the corner behind the goal line. Trying to backhand it towards the front far post. Cleared up to the blue line. Pass Shelberg. He'll catch it just outside of the blue line. We're back to five-a-side hockey. And here's Pitra across the line. Pitra couldn't get a control of it there to take it towards the net. Goes off over to the half boards. In the Patriots zone, Green turnaround shot, Mikkel Munil. Holding on to it as he sees some pressure coming from the captain, James Durko.
All right, I let it stew for a while.
Yeah?
The non-shutout streak.
Oh, sorry.
The Fairfax, the Spina Joint Institute of Fairfax trivia question. The longest non-shutout streak, that's games without a shutout, is 264. Whether you count the playoffs or not, two different teams.
Wow. I have a guess.
Now, keep in mind, just non-shutout. Doesn't mean you're terrible, because Phil guessed Washington, and it is not. You don't have to be terrible.
Oh, that was a nice
your goalies hit. Aren't good enough.
That was a low blow.
Well, I mean, the Capitals have the record for the season and most goals against it. And
yeah.
a slew of records
but that was in
for
the
that 1974-75 yeah. inaugural season.
Yeah.
Where they went with just eight wins.
74-75 was not their inaugural. 71-72, I thought.
71-72 was the first year of the Atlanta Flames and the New York Islanders. 74-75 was the first year of the Washington Capitals and the Kansas City Scouts.
Oh, okay.
Who are they now, yes. Dave? Who are the Scouts?
They're the Colorado Avalanche.
No.
Wait, what? No, the Devils.
They are the Devils. Yeah, they were the Colorado
the
Rockies
that's right,
for
that's
a
right.
set of years.
That's right. That's
they are
thinking.
Currently the New Jersey Devils.
That's what I was thinking of.
So, 264 is the number. Who's the team? I'll ask for your guesses next break.
Okie dokie. 17:30 left here in the third. 6-0. Yeah, you are right. 74. How about that? And now we have a delayed call. Somebody's getting tossed into the box. I'm going to write mine down. I'm going to say it's yeah. Okay. I'm going to go with L.A. and Edmonton. Oh, okay. So two of us have L.A. in there. Johnny's writing down things. Writing down his memoir. Very beautiful tale. 17-24 remains here in the third. 6-0 Richmond Generals. John Baranowski is feverishly writing. And Shrems is taking a bite of whatever the heck that was. We all heard that. Sounds delicious.
It was his,
what is it?
The cheesy balls.
Yeah. Yeah, his planter's cheese balls.
Mm-hmm.
What? You eating your planter's cheese balls down there? 17-20 left here.
Somebody tell me when my mic's on and I'm eating something
yes,
this time?
Yes.
This segment of Chico Eats here with the New York Islanders.
Announce the calls. Alrighty. So my guess was LA and Edmonton. Those are my two teams. Phil says Chicago and LA. Those are our answers up here, Johnny. Now we'll take it over to the near corner of the Patriots zone up top. Here Scott winds up, takes his shot, redirected by the ankle of his own player up front. That was McHenry. Wisniewski trying to take his shot through traffic. Christian got in the way of that one. And through center, it's Tyler Height launching this one in on to Buckmeyer, and he holds on. Kyle Dooley is going to charge into Scott. Wrong Scott. It's not John Scott. It's Jack Scott.
Shrems, your guess?
My official guess is going to be... No, hold on.
Well, maybe we'll get a normal call at some point where... I'll have a chance to actually go through this stuff without having to write everything down.
Face off to the left of Mikkel Munil as a result of Kyle Dooley's penalty. 31-12 shots in favor of Richmond along with a 6-0 score. Green with the faceoff win over to Durko. Half boards. Here's the call.
Dooley, 2 minutes from off. Dooley, 2 for off against 16-13. On the open, still
could just use the acronym, John. Over to the near side of the neutral zone.
Shouldn't it all season. Nobody's using it.
I know. Pierce pushes it towards the front, and there's a shot attempt there. Nice block there by Colton Heupel. Heupel loses an edge there. Doyeren near half boards, and he'll sauce this one out, and Heupel couldn't get a hold of it there as it just whizzed past him. Shelberg up ahead now for Pitra. Pitra across the line, near half boards, down and behind the goal line. Tries to work his way to the front. Shiahama will cut it off there, and Kay will launch this one down a length of the ice, right down past Buckmeyer. But behind Buckmeyer's cage, Shiahama wins the race with the puck there. Almost took out Buckmeyer in the process. 1 minute to kill on the All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater penalty kill. 15-12 left here in the third. It's 6-0 Richmond in this USP3 contest. Durko through center. Across the Patriots line. Scoops it over for Green. Green trying to push it into the circle there for somebody, but Patriots will find it and launch it down the ice. Buckmeyer almost giving one in. That was an interesting turn of events. And this one cleared all the way down the lake of the ice. No icing. Mikkel Monell's out there. He'll scoop around over to the near side. Back around over to the far corner. Over the half boards it goes. Krishnan trying to get a hold of it here. Can't find an exit. Now he does. Pass Scott. Goes in front of the timekeeper's bench. And he'll be cleared right back in by the Generals. Not deep enough there. It'll be cleared up the glove of McPherson. Man, he is tall. Now we're back to five-side hockey. 14-10 left here in the third. 6-0 Richmond, and we have a collision in front of the Patriots bench. And a backhand shot there off the side of the net. Manel holding it. And the whistles are going here. And trying to pitchfork it in out of the Generals with 14:03 left here in the third. Back on the ice is Patrick Patapas. He has served his time. John is writing feverishly. It's a memoir of his. And Tibbs is going to go to the box for a slash. Keep writing, John. We want to hear every detail of your life. His memoir is going to be about that thing. It's going to be like War and Peace. It's going to include a score sheet from a Potomac Patriots Richmond Generals game. Face off to the left of Buckmeyer. 14:03 left here in the third. 6-0 Richmond. Will they strike now? Maybe. Guidi will take the face off for Potomac. One off out of the far half boards and up and out and sent down to like the S. Here's Yanni. Is it one tip or is it two?
Multiple.
Okay. Just making sure. The first time he said it was Tib, like Mr. Pibb, and then it became Tibbs. And up to the blue line and out over to the near side of the neutral zone. Heupel trying to wrangle it up. And it's the Generals. I wish you were up here, Shrums. And it's cleared all the way down to Mikkel Monell. Oh, nice work there, but it's clear up to the point. Hilbert with a shot and a save by Manil. Near side, Heupel. And cross ice feed on four. Richard Key with a shot. He misses the pad there. Buckmeyer looking for the inside of the near post. And up top, Shiohama looking. Up top for Doyeren. Doyeren patiently. Pulls the trigger through the traffic and it deflects just wide. Right idea. To the near side, into the corner, Shiahama. 12:45 left here in the third. 40 seconds left on the cross ice feed power play. Enjoy running along near side boards. Here's Kay. Kay, far circle, with a shot. Saved by Buckmeyer. Using his head on that one. Shiahama pulling the trigger. And trying to work his way through. Guidi kept in there. Sent down low. Jason Guidi trying to get a hold of it, and this one finds its way down the length of the ice. And Mikkel Monell all the way out of his cage here to put it along near wing for Doyeren across the line. Through the feet of Selankiewicz. Chasing it down as Pertapas. 5 seconds left on a man advantage. 12:08 left here in the third. 6-0 Richmond. That one's set up down low. And it was cut off by the Generals, who are back to even strength. Are we ever going to get an answer on that trivia question? Oh, goodness. It's killing me. And out through center, across the Richmond line. Patriots putting it in deep now. Green will pick it up along the half boards, far side, and he'll sweep it out. Down like the ice, deflecting, no icing. Soliday will get there at the hash marks inside of his own zone. Through center for Tyler Height. Height dropping it ahead now for Krishnan with a drop pass there. Tappas was the intended target. Instead, it'll be played by Green ahead now for Tibbs. Tibbs did not get a full feel for that pass and just kind of lightly floated towards the net. Now it's up along the far boards of the Patriots zone. Green, the point shot, a save there by Minnell. Backhanded up top here. Norris stepping into it here. He'll keep it in along over to the near corner. Half boards. No, it's poked away. And it's a foot race now with Height. But instead it'll be taken and sent out into the neutral zone by McPherson. Here's Soliday trying to sidestep McPherson, but McPherson pokes it ahead. Trying to set up a breakaway there. The linesman got in the way of it. Connor Green was a bigger... Connor Green was off to the races there, but did not receive the puck. What is the answer? What is the answer? We'll never know. 10:35 left here in the third. 6-0 Richmond Generals. Johnny's making friends. Far circle it goes. Generals looking to make it 7. Vreeland lost an edge there. Now top of the slot with a shot, and that one misses the glove of McPherson. And then near side glass and out. McPherson loved and stick that one right in on Minnell. Minnell will hold on. And we'll get a face off here as well.
All right, we have an actual stoppage, a real stoppage. Wow. Oh, my goodness, I'm not writing.
Quick, everybody go. Okay,
go.
I'm going Chicago and Ottawa.
Okay, Phil says Chicago and L.A. I say L.A. and Edmonton.
L.A. is the answer for the playoff one. If you include the playoffs, the L.A. Kings from 1986 through 1989 did not have a shutout.
God, that's 3 years.
Hey, Phil and I. Okay.
The other answer, the the regular season only,
delayed
the
penalty.
Calgary Flames, 81-85.
I was off by one.
No shutouts.
I was
4 years.
By one. I said Edmonton. I was close. So I get the consolation prize, which is Schrems' pack of Dunkaroos over there.
That's 4 years without a shutout.
That's ridiculous. Wisniewski's going to go back to the box. He hasn't been there in a while. He spent 12 minutes in it earlier. Now he's got 14 minutes in penalties.
Who is tending? Was Vernon back then? Vernon starting?
Yeah, it's got to be. 9:55 left here in the third. It's a cross-ice feed power play. Let's call Pepco and find out if the power is on. Shelberg, a face-off win over to the near corner, and it's cleared up and nut out. A lot of overcharging going on here.
Stole my joke.
I know. Back behind Manil. Breakout starting here. Methodically through center. Trying to move it for Shiahama. Doyron will get it back at the red line, though. Pull up for an open wing over to the near side for Malloy. Malloy towards the front. Krishnan trying to step into it, but the Richmond Generals will push it out along the near side board. Toe and a hard check there by Malloy on Hilibert. M&M will clear it up along the glass and out, but Slankwitz will toss it right back in. 9:05 left here in the third. Power play. Tyler Height. Sidestepping Slankwitz, cross the line he goes. Winds up, takes a shot. Buchmeyer to save the rebound. This works past him. Goes off along the far side of the net, back behind the cage. Richmond with it now. Slankwitz, and we have a delayed call. And it's a cross-checking call. And it looks like Kyle Dooley. .849 left here in the third. 4-on-4 hockey for the next 54 seconds. Wake up, Phil.
I don't snore.
Forgot his CPAP machine, he fell asleep. 8:49 left here in the third. It's 4-on-4 hockey, 6-0 Richmond Generals. Faceoff will be to the right of Mikkel Minnell, who's only allowed one goal in relief.
Yeah.
And finally, the faceoff is won by the Patriots. Set up along the glass, trying to hook up with Colton Heupel, but it's sent right back in by the Generals. Solid out, trying to get it onto the tape of Guidi. Guidi couldn't handle the pass there. It was deflected off his stick, and Vreeland will chase it. Here's a call. The All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater penalty kill. Visit a local All-American Steakhouse and Sports Theater near you. Location here in Woodbridge at Lake Ridge, and one nearby in Manassas. And that one works its way to the front. Mikkel Manil going to hold on to it.
Okay. I'm ready. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, for your third period, clearly Canadian trivia question, clearly Canadian, always drink clear. There have been two players to attend the playoffs with their respective teams every single year of their career. One was Larry Robinson. That's the one that nobody would have gotten. Who is the other player to make the playoffs with their respective team every single year of their career?
Clearly, it's Mark Messier again. Why is Mark Messier always the answer to these trivia questions? Over to the near side.
I'll do the big reveal here in about 3-4 minutes.
Okay, sounds good. Tweet your answers at Cross Ice Feed. They just keep pouring in. You know, I'll try to keep up with all the tweets. There's a lot of tweeting going on in here. 33 seconds left to kill on Dooley's penalty. 7:20 left here in the third. 6-0 Richmond Generals. Hashtag PPATS. Buckmeyer setting it up behind his net there. Now we'll return back to five-a-side hockey. Tibbs getting checked by Malloy. Malloy tried to slap the puck in, inadvertently slapping Tibbs. And the Patriots really, really need to find a silver lining here because I need a goal. They need a goal. They're down over the far corner and back behind Buckmeyer. He's only seen 15 shots. We've got some activity going on behind the play here. Or it could be in a spectator area. I don't know. Heard some noise somewhere in the vicinity of the rink. And it's a whistle. It's offside. 6:07 says the clock. 2 weeks' time, we're back here against the Carolina Eagles, January 30th and 31st. We'll double check on these times. It looks like we have a 9 p.m. start for the USP3 game that Saturday.
All right, Dave. You said Mark Messier.
Yeah.
I think Wayne Gretzky is probably the other obvious one.
Oh.
Wow, okay.
We got a run clock? Really? His reaction of wow. Okay.
Tibbs is going to the box. A 5-minute major for a high stick.
There all you the all-you-can-score buffet has been activated.
Wow. I hope they brought their appetites. Oh, wow. No sneeze guard at this buffet. Let's hope they dig in, huh? It's like a trough. The shot from the point blocked up front. Let's get the call from here's Johnny.
Richmond Generals penalty number 77, Robert Tibbs. 5-minute major for high sticking. Tibbs, a 5-minute major for high sticking at 6:07.
Next time, make sure the boom box is off before you turn on your mic. I was shouting, here's Johnny for everybody. And there's a shorthanded goal for Richmond. Getting that goal is Tristan Hilbert. 7-0. 5:39 left here in the third period. Richmond is up by a touchdown and the point after touchdown. There's Kay. Whoa, Kay gets charged into there with a heart check. Short-handed goal for Hilibert. Shiohama across the line. Takes his shot, Buckmeyer, this glove save. 5-9, left down the third, 7-0, Richmond. All you can score, Buffet, 4 minutes, 2 seconds. Face-off, one up top. Here's Soliday. Soliday looking for the lane. No, he gives it over to the half-boards. Here comes Christian. Christian gets taken out from underneath him. That was the most obvious trip I've ever seen. Could have been a 5-on-3, but hey, who's counting here? Buckmeyer with a shot, a save there, and off the shot, and it comes up top, and the bouncing puck can't wrangle it down. Soliday. Over to the near side for Heupel. Heupel across the line. There for Christian. Back to Heupel. Heupel looks towards the front. He had height. Puck rocketed past him. Yeah, it was back up top. Here's Soliday. Winds up, fakes a shot, sends it down low into the corner. Near side, Krishnan. Heupel. Back up top to Soliday. They got a lot of time. No, they don't. 3:19 left here in the, well, the man advantage. Oh, you can score Buffet. 4:26 left here in the third. 7-0 Richmond. They need to start taking more shots here. They have to score seven.
So the clearly Canadian trivia question of the third period. Larry Robinson was one. Who is the only other player in NHL history to reach the playoffs every single year of their career? Go.
I said Mark Messier, but I'm probably wrong. It's probably Steve Yzerman.
Yeah, I said Gretzky, but I'm told I'm wrong. So I'm trying to think now.
The answer is very obvious.
Yeah, that throws me.
Here's a turnaround shot right in. Is it
Scott Stevens?
Very good guess. Not Messier or Stevens. Anything from Fritz up there? Or?
Ken Dryden. He says Ken Dryden.
Ken Dryden. Wow.
I mean, six cups in 8 years, that actually might be true.
Not true. Your answer, Mr. Nicholas Lidstrom.
Wow. You know, I thought that moment. I'm like, no.
Very good trivia question.
That's a very good trivia question.
I figured it was going to be a Red Wing, yeah. After I was told Messier was wrong. Anyway.
If you
here's a shot that just goes wide. 3:38 left here in the third. All you can score, Buffet, 2.5 minutes left on it. Nothing happening yet. We're waiting. It's like waiting for the announcement of the next Pope. We're waiting to see the black smoke. Or is it the white smoke? I can't remember. Up top, Toymerick. Look at the pull the trigger. Takes it through traffic. Buckmeyer makes the save. And Kay trying to work his way to the front there. And this one's rifled all the way down. Miguel Minnell. Going to get a hold of it here at the goal line. 3:05 left here in the third. 1:58 left on the... All you can score Buffet, which apparently has gone vegan. And everyone stays away from that buffet. That's why we haven't gotten a goal yet. Bertapas across the line. Maybe he'll go vegan and get one. Heupel, far half boards. Down low it goes, behind the goal line. It's Height. Look it. For an option to open up here, find Guidi up top. Guidi scores! It's finger licking good. He gets a cross ice feed power play goal. All right, they have a minute and 26 left on the all you can score buffet. A couple more laser guided Guidi shots. Whew. Thought my daughter's tongue twister books for bedtime were confusing. That statement had me going. 2:33 left here in the third. 7-1. Finally, Potomac finds a goal.
Potomac entries goal! Scored by number 8, Jason Guidi. Assisted by number 72, Dalton.
don't plug us. Don't. Here's Heupel with a shot. It gets deflected. And another shot there. And oh, what a save there by Buckmeyer. Oh, wow. 50 seconds left on the All You Can Score buffet. 1:57 left here in the third. There's plenty of time left.
So I've been reading a lot of my favorite hockey writer, Brian McFarlane, a true hockey historian.
Who?
Brian McFarlane, actually operated a small museum outside of Niagara Falls for a while.
Yep.
The owner of Peter Puck, if you want to know who he is.
Oh, okay.
Hockey Night in Canada broadcaster for many, many years.
There's a shot there and a save.
I was hoping that'd be another save and a whistle. That way I could get another one going, but...
Yeah. Here's a redirect here. Pass. Buckmeyer, but it goes wide. Pertapis. Got a stick on that one. Here comes Kay. Kay looking for a lane. Winds up. Takes a shot. And he teed that one up. Goes well out of the reach. And Doyeron keeps it in. Well done. Nice keep. Fed over for Kay. Kay, please score. Takes a shot. Buckmeyer. Yeah, made a save on that one. Shiohama on the one time. Set up. And now Doyeron will keep it. Over for Shiohama. Far halfwards. Looking for options. Up top. Doyeron. Back for Shiohama. Kay's waiting. Kay won't get it. And he'll get it on a second attempt here as he chases it down along the near halfwards. Kay sidestepping here. Gives it up for Doyeron. Doyeron takes the shot and it goes wide of the cage. Final score, Buffalo defeats Washington 4-1. Up top, Pertapis pulling the trigger. Oh, and it deflects just wide. 1 minute left here in the third. 7-1 Richmond. Down below the goal line. Here's a shot from the far post and a save by Buckmeyer. And over to the far halfwards, Kay. Working with it now with Heupel. Heupel. Heupel over to the far corner.
Hey, Stearns, I can see your buddy over, or I can hear your buddy from down
That's
here.
That's why I said you should be up here. top of the far, or top of the slot here, and it goes out, and Tibbs will have it. Tibbs. Comes in, takes a shot, and it goes above the cage and over to the near corner. 25 seconds left here in the third. Heupel, miscommunication there. Jerko trying to feed it to the front to Tibbs. And 10 seconds remains here. Nice surge of energy out of that goal, but it's unfortunate that they're going to fall to the Richmond Generals with a final score of 7-1. Game two tomorrow. Down in Richmond, 0.5 seconds left. We'll just call it there.
All right, I'll cap off this game with my last thought, that thought I started from Brian McFarlane.
Yeah?
In the 70s, Montreal Canadiens coach Jacques Demers was talking to his team, trying to get them going for a game. He says, this is the kind of game that separates the men from the boys. So let's go, boys, and charge out of the locker room.
With that being said, the Richmond Generals are victorious in this one with a final score of 7-1. What's that? What? Trems? Hey, oh. 7-1 is your final score. 7-1 is your final score in this one in this USPHL USP3 contest. Richmond victorious. We'll do it all over again tomorrow down in Richmond. That game slated to start at 4:30 on Fast Hockey. Thanks for tuning in, everybody, as always. Don't stop believing. We'll see you in a couple of weeks.